doing.
Do you want?
Let's do an applause.
So when we get together to talk about documentation, we like to talk about beginnings. We like to talk about onboarding new users, generating API keys, dealing with authorization and hassle. We like to talk about the sort of middle events for our users, troubleshooting problems, advocating for new features. But something we don't really talk about so much is endings. We act like our software is going to live forever, but it happens all the time that teams are reorganized, or projects are discontinued, or companies go bankrupt. And if you haven't worked on a canceled project yet, if you kind of stick around the software business long enough, it'll probably happen to you someday. It happened to me not too long ago that I worked on a project that things seemed to be going well, and then it ended. And I have no doubt you've experienced it as a user, where a tool that you come to rely upon and trust has gone away, and you know what a burden that is to get that email that says, "Hey, it's time for you to go." I cannot be the only person who is still angry that Google Reader went away. So what we're going to talk about today is what happens when your API comes to an end. And we're going to talk about that to sort of take away the threat of that thing, and to talk about how we can make the most of that situation. And specifically, this talk is about getting three things right. First, getting your mindset right. Shutdowns are a really fraught situation. They can be very stressful or exciting, and that requires some kind of attention to how we're going to relate to our users, our teammates. It's about getting the planning right. So having a plan is essential. This is not one of those things that you can iterate on. You get one chance to shut down your project, and then it's done. And lastly, getting the content and style right to actually say these things to your users. It's not a lot of content, but it does require some attention. First, a brief word on terminology. Shutdown is kind of a loaded term, but deprecation often means the same thing for your users. So when you have your big version 2.0 API, and finally it's time to get people out of that version 1, that to you might not seem like a huge thing, but to your users that might actually be a really disruptive change. And so it's important to maybe start thinking about deprecations, big deprecations, as a shutdown in its own right. So feelings around shutdowns are going to be complicated. And this is really going to depend on sort of the situation that you find yourself in when the API does have to shut down. You might be very, very happy. It might be that your API is shutting down because your company got acquired and you're about to get a really big payday. You might be relieved. Maybe this long-standing maintenance burden is going to go away. And this headache that you've had is you're gonna finally be relieved of that. Or you might be scared. Maybe your company is faltering and this API is going away because something is not in good shape. Or you might be angry. Maybe just a project that you've been working on for a really long time and that you've been personally invested in got shot down by management, and they decided, no, we're going in a different direction, and nothing to do with you, but this was gonna happen. And so all these feelings, being happy or relieved or angry or scared, these are all completely reasonable, but it's not really something you want to inflict on others, on your teammates or on your users. And if you're going to help your users, you're going to need to get your head around this. We talk about software as if it's all rational, but the work that we do is significant and it's meaningful. And so if you're going to be upset about this, or you're going to be happy about this, that's normal and ordinary, but you need to manage it. And really, you need to manage it for yourself, and also you need to manage it for your teammates and for your users, because you're having an easy time with this doesn't necessarily mean they are. So the first thing to do when that decision is made to shut down an API is to avoid committing to near future action. The more time you can buy yourself, the better this process will go. It may be the case that management or shareholders or some other stakeholder is imposing kind of rough deadlines on you, that things need to happen very, very quickly, even though you may need some time to sort things out. If you can, you can push back on those things, if you can. If you can't, then on some level you might need to just accept that someone's made a decision for you and your users to be miserable, and you're just gonna have to cope with that. If you can do some of the things in this talk, that's great. If not, then that's okay too. Just like look out for something. So the next thing to do is to take the time to integrate this new fact into your working life. If this was like a big important project to you, you know, this may be like legitimately like time to breathe. A few hours are really good. Take your team to the pub and gripe about this situation or cheer about it, if that's what it is. If you have a few days, you can wait to actually do any of the shutdown work until the following Monday. You know, that's really awesome. But after you've done that sort of socialization of talking about, you know, what the shutdown is and what it means, go just by yourself and with a pad of paper and write down what you've achieved and what you've learned. This has two really great benefits. One, it'll be a nice thing to be able to refer to later for your CV, particularly if your company's having issues, you might need that. But also, this is a concrete task that you can do yourself that kind of begins to move this project forward. And that is something that will help to like make this a concrete project that will sort of moderate your feelings about it. Next is to take stock of your user base. How many requests have you got? How many API tokens have you issued? How many billing clients do you have? How many people look at your documentation every month? This is your audience. For people who write documentation, this is perversely, this is a very big opportunity for you. It's not often that you get to write something that you know that every single one of your current users needs to see and read and understand. And so you have a chance to do something that has a really big impact. And it's not often that you get that. The next thing to do is to remind yourself that you're not your user, and you're not your teammates, and you're your manager, or your shareholders. And acknowledge and respect that your experience is going to be different from theirs. Really, you're going to kind of want to filter everything that you do going forward through this thought, that to say that your users and that your users are going to have some closeness to this project, they're going to have some distance from it that you're not going to have, and that you're going to have to kind of accommodate that and work that. Particularly as this project of shutting down your project continues, your sort of goals and interests will start to diverge. So once you've calibrated yourself, now it's time to make a plan about your API and about how you're going to communicate with your users. This is something you cannot do in isolation. You need to involve the people on your team that have a big stake in this problem. Especially, there's basically three areas that I think are really important to consider are support. Your support team is going to be the front line of communications with your users, and they're going to be an important part of communicating this change and helping them deal with it. Operations, so you're going to be making changes to your API through this process, very likely. It's not likely you're just going to flip the switch and walk out of the room one day. That you're going to be making technical decisions and then communicating those decisions to users. And so you'll want to involve them. And engineering, likewise. You're not going to simply do things kind of off the cuff. Excuse me. The first thing on your plan should be to stop existing outreach. You probably have a lot of communications that are sort of on autopilot, like your blog or social media. You might be doing drip marketing, sending the sequence of emails to encourage users to sign up or use the service in a different way. You might be running ads to promote your service. You need to put all of that on pause. You don't want to be talking at cross purposes to yourself. Don't want to be, it happened to me once that I got an email that the service that I was using was shutting down. And then, like maybe about an hour later, I got this automated email saying, don't forget to refer a friend to use the service. That's not the kind of mixed signals you want to be sending. Once you have identified kind of the things you need to pause, then it's time to start looking at how you're going to communicate this new information to your users. And it helps to go through all of your communication channels, really spell out what they are, and figure out how you can use them. There's actually a bunch of them. Email is going to be huge. You probably have newsletters that you send out from time to time. You may also have transactional email, so billing, quota usage, other little messages that are part of the process of using your software. You're going to maybe be able to use those messages as places to put reminders to people. Like, hey, this service is going away. Don't forget. Your blog is going to be a sort of maybe Grand Central for announcing this change, right? This is probably a big place where you're going to drive communications, and that's something you're going to want to consider. You may be using social media. You may want to use social media. And it's a good way to do sort of those recurring reminders as you get closer and closer to the day you shut down to say, hey, don't forget, this is coming. And you know, it may be that you have developers using your API that they're not looking that closely at the email that you send, or they're not reading your blog, but they might be on Twitter. And so that's maybe a good place to remind people. Your support team has lots of communications channels that are going to be useful in this situation. They likely use some kind of support tool to track issues with customers. They'll also likely to have phone support or email or chat. They are opportunities to have one-on-one communications with users about this change that's coming. Sales is maybe a lesser known option here. Sales account managers often have like really good relationship with individual customers, and so this is another opportunity for one-on-one communications. Your UI. The actual like user interface that maybe you've got probably a UI for issuing API tokens, that you're going to have an opportunity there to say, hey, this token that you're generating now, it's expiring in 3 weeks, not 3 years. Here's why. The API itself can be a communications channel. If you haven't already, if you don't already have some kind of facility for issuing deprecation notices or status messages sort of in line with regular normal responses, this is probably not the time to engineer one, but if you've got one to use, that's great. If not, you do actually sort of have a few exotic options for the API as a communications channel. For instance, in advance of the final shutdown, you could have a brief temporary outage to call attention to the fact that this thing is really going to shut down soon. Your team or your company may run events or go to events where there are lots of users of your API. This is a place to reach out to them. And oh yeah, you've got a documentation site probably that you can use to tell people what's going to happen and how it's going to happen. Once you have those channels to work with, then you can kind of think about how those channels are going to fit into the overall kind of communication escalation strategy. It's likely that your communications in this sort of situation are going to have two distinct peaks, where you're going to have an initial announcement, where there's a big flurry of communications, where there's going to be lots of questions, there's going to be a lot to say. And then you'll have a period of sort of steady, lower intensity reminders that the end is coming. And then a final extinction burst, when you actually shut down the API and eventually go silent. Next thing to do is to make a schedule, to take those channels and how you're going to use them, to map that escalation strategy onto the actual workday. And a good way to do this is to take out a calendar, mark today and the last day your API is expected to be operating. And then first to eliminate dates where you actually don't want to do anything at all. You want to avoid making announcements or changes on public holidays, both yours and those in the countries of your users. You want to avoid existing plans for you and your team. If somebody important is going to be on vacation, you do not want to be serious changes that rely on that person. Similarly, if you have like a company offsite, that's not a great time to field a bunch of communication, a bunch of support questions. And just for your own personal sanity, just like cross out every Friday afternoon. You also want to include support and operations in this scheduling, that you don't want to overstep like support shift boundaries or on-call rotations, just to avoid making any changes that are going to be very difficult to respond to. You also want to give yourself a little bit of slack near the end for one-on-one outreach. As you get to the end of your API, you may have some stragglers, and it will be useful to have a little bit of time to do individual outreach to those people and say, hey, this is a personal email from so-and-so on the team. We see that you're still on the API. You're sending us a lot of requests. Can we do anything to help you not do that? One last thing to consider for making a schedule is to think in terms of no earlier than dates rather than hard deadlines. So for instance, maybe at some point in this shutdown process, you're going to want to delete a lot of data. Maybe you've got a bunch of user data that you're not going to use anymore and needs to go away. You don't really want to be guaranteeing to your readers that on June 30th, this data will be deleted. It's probably easier for you to say something more like, starting on June 30th, this data will be deleted. That way, it's clear to your users that there's no guarantee beyond that date, but this gives you time to do things like handle like legal data retention laws, right? You need to maybe sift through the data that you have and separate it into what you can and cannot delete. Once you've got a schedule, then you got to the easy part. And this is just what to say to your readers and to write it down. This is the last 10% of this effort, really. There is actually not that much content to write. There's just a few questions that your readers are going to have about the shutdown, but it is a sort of sensitive kind of documentation to write because how you say it is going to have a big impact on the reaction you get from your readers. So the essential thing here is to be calm, gentle, and direct. This is not the time for subtlety. This is not the time to sort of ease into this message by going, oh, well, we've got some bad news for you, but first let me tell you about some other things. Like, you know, you really do want to get right to the point that the API is shutting down, and it's happening, and this is going to be something you're going to have to deal with. It doesn't mean to be cruel. You do need to be sensitive to the fact that you're imposing a burden on your users, but if your house style calls for like a jokey or friendly tone, this is probably not the time for that sort of thing. There's this cliche about when startups get acquired and they shut down their service because they are getting that pay to talk about our incredible journey. And it's really a projection onto the user that oh, aren't you excited for us that this is happening? When really, you know, that's a really big difference between, you know, your experience and their experience, that this is something that's maybe just very disruptive for them and very positive for you, and it's, you don't want to be thinking about it in terms of yourself when you talk to users. It really does not need to be about you, it needs to be about them. So how do you do that? Just the facts. You need to answer a few concrete questions. So what is happening in concrete terms? You might have a concept for what deprecation or shutdown means, and you may understand that pretty well, but you need to give your users an illustration of what that actually is, right? This means that the API is going to stop responding to requests at some point. This means that maybe a final bill will be sent at some point. Maybe this means support will not be available on a certain date or time. It helps to really make it clear what you mean when something is going away. When is it happening? So what are the major milestones and when are they going to take place? This is maybe the most essential part of this shutdown document that you're going to write. you basically need to spell out that on this date we've made this announcement, and then each of the major milestones for the process of actually shutting it down. So it may be that on a particular date you won't be able to create a new account. It may be that on a particular date you won't be able to generate a new API key. On a particular date, the API will stop functioning. What are those dates? Or if different parts of the API go away at different times, when does that happen? And then the last question is, what do I need to do? And this is really like, what does this mean for me? How do I have to react to this? If you can give that answer to your users, it'll be really helpful. In a way, this is about giving them an exit. And what an exit looks like in your particular situation, you know, you might need to bring some creativity to this process. As they say, when you hear the airline safety announcement, the nearest exit may be behind you. You know, if you find yourself, you know, a competitor has undercut you, and you know you can no longer sustain this API. Maybe you can, if you want to be a real class act, write out a tutorial for here's how you migrate to an alternative service. This is a really great way to generate a lot of goodwill around your API's last days. There is one last question that comes up sometimes, and that's why. And this is a really touchy area. Really, you don't owe anybody an explanation. Retiring to drink Mai Tais on the beach is just as legitimate as running out of money. And you can make that decision. Like, whatever that is, like, you can do that, and you don't really owe it to your users to explain why you've done it. You can say if you want to, but you need to be careful to phrase it in a way that doesn't open a negotiation. You've made a decision, you're following through. Do not muddy the waters with the hope that your API is going to come out of this. It's not. You know, if you say something like, oh, well, we would love to keep going, but you know, not enough revenue, we're just, you know, can't get enough from this business, you know, you don't really want to get the noise of, oh, well, can you increase the subscription rate for the API? It's just, you've already done the work of making this happen, and you don't need to necessarily answer this question, unless you want to, unless you're going to do it carefully. There is one last thing to write, which is to say thank you. This is a sort of funny situation. The worst case scenario is not, you know, you send out this announcement, your API is shutting down, and you get a bunch of angry users. The worst case scenario is that nobody cares. And it may be that you have a few people who are angry, but showing a bit of gratitude can go a long ways to neutralizing those bad feelings. Aviators have a saying that a good landing is one that you can walk away from. This process will not be a lot of fun. But you can have a really big impact. You can take something that could be just a devastating experience for you and your users and turn it into something that's just like sort of mildly annoying. And that's pretty good. And so if you can get everyone out of your service in a timely manner, then you've done a good job by yourself and by your users. And that means there would be only one thing left to do, which is to take another trip to the pub and raise a glass to your dearly visitors.